Here are some gathers which have been NMO corrected, but I can see a small amount of residual moveout that could also be removed. Turning on the amplitude graph shows the deviation from horizontal and the corresponding drop in amplitude for several different slices. The gathers have been muted, but there's a little bit of NMO stretch remaining in the shallow far offsets. I'll start by calculating a 50 degree angle mute and displaying it over the gather. I will use this mute to limit the range of my RMO calculations. To start RMO picking, we'll need an episode. Click on Imaging, create a new episode, and give it a name. Select the episode and create some new RMO picks. Type a name that reflects the picking type. Select the gathers volume. There are three types of RMO picking: parabolic, non-parabolic, and effective eta. Select parabolic and click OK. Adjust the parameters panel size to see the values more clearly. Azimuth is a required field, but is not used unless I need the picks for ray tracing. For this RMO example, we'll use 0 degrees. I can limit the calculations with inner and outer mutes. This is where I choose that 50 degree angle mute. As it evaluates each gather, InSight calculates the semblance for each different parabolic path and picks the one with the highest. The analysis window is determined by a top and base value, defined by horizons or constants. I will run mine from 1000 milliseconds to 4000 milliseconds, the end of the trace. Each set of RMO picks can have different display settings and colours, handy if you need to compare results. With the settings complete, I can see several parabola showing the picks based on the peak semblance values. I can select the semblance data in this gamma volume to include a new track showing the semblance. The semblance shows the stacked energy for a particular parabolic path. The gamma value measures the deviation from a flat event. The gamma range limits the modelling window for the picks. A perfectly flat pick has a value of 1. This range limits the curvature of the picks generated by the RMO process. Other important parameters to control picking are the minimum semblance and the minimum pick spacing. With these settings, picks must be at least 500 milliseconds apart and must have a semblance above 0.75. With the minimum semblance reduced to 0, InSight adds a pick every 500 milliseconds. With higher resolution in the shallower data, I can accurately calculate more picks. To do this, I'll adjust the minimum pick spacing at the top to 50 milliseconds. At the top of the interval, the picks are closely spaced and deeper down, they get more sparse. Let's see what happens when I increase the interval at the base to 50 milliseconds. This is clearly a bad configuration. However, if I zoom in, it shows a good example of a possible problem. If the gamma range is too wide, or the picks are too closely spaced together, the picks can cross over. This is an invalid result, and will lead to warnings later. I'll adjust the minimum interval at the base to 150 milliseconds. Much better. We can use multiple picking windows with different parameters for each. When we change the windows, we need to reselect the semblance volume. Here the upper interval has a spacing of 50, increasing to 250. And the lower interval has a spacing of 250. With the minimum pick spacing set correctly, I'll adjust the minimum semblance to 0.6 at the top of the interval, interpolated to 0.5 at the base, and exclude any low confidence picks. I'll need to adjust the window length for each of these intervals. The closely spaced picks need a shorter analysis window than the widely spaced picks. The analysis window length is interpolated from layer to layer. When I navigate through the gathers, InSight calculates the picks at each location. With a quick pass through the data, I can see that the picks are well behaved. Great! These picks look ready for the shifts to be calculated. I'm done here. If you have questions or would like to discover more, then visit our website at www.dog.com. And remember, have fun with insight.